A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That was how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean Sea. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. We're on the French Riviera once more this weekend at the 2-mile-long Circuit de Monaco. The cars will climb around 40 metres up the hill, past the casino, and then descend downwards towards the harbour through Sector 2. It's a very short run from pole position to the first of the 19 corners at Saint-Devot. And don't expect to see much overtaking here today. Anthony Davidson, a very warm welcome to you as you join me in the commentary box for today's event. Let's talk about Olsen. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
They've been avoiding mistakes and have had solid pace, so it's been a good season so far, but whether they can keep that up long term remains to be seen.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Olsen lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Max Verstappen, and Raikkonen, Albon, Bottas, Norris, and Devon Butler, Perez, Ricciardo, Lucas Faber, and Giovinazzi. Sainz, Kvyat, Kevin Magnussen, and George Russell, Grosjean, and Robert Kubica takes the last spot on the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Okay, it's a short run to Saint-Devot, and you know what Monaco's like, so try to defend this lead. Teammate by 4.8 seconds. They're on fresh softs. They're in 12th. The time last lap was a 1 minute 31.1. Race officials have enabled DRS. DRS is now available. Charger is on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. Than a second, they're on fresh softs. This is your final lap of the race. Absolutely fantastic. It's a brilliant result. Well done.
It was a magnificent race and a drive right out of the top draw to take the win for Renault. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
As today's winners make their way up the podium steps, the team at Renault have shown once again what it takes to build a successful Formula One team. A well-deserved win for them. We'll be right back. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Olsen increases their championship lead. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Well, you can't fault anything that Sergio Perez did out on the track today. He drove flawlessly, making him an easy pick.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The current championship leaders still hold top spot, but that gap is getting smaller. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that.
You're surpassing all expectations. Can anything or anyone stop you?
Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash? Appreciate your time.